Hey, what's going on, guys? Carl here with Trilobyte Studios, along with my cohort, Josh, who is manning the camera.
Right. Hello.
That's going to be a lovely shot. So today we're doing something really cool. We figured what better way to kick off the channel than to actually go and look for some fossils of the namesake of the channel. So today we're going back to the Devonian period. There's a fossil formation. I won't tell you, I'll tell you where it is, but I'll say we live kind of close to it, hour or two drive. There's a fossil formation that is an entire Devonian coral reef that has been fossilized. This is a well-known location, and so we're just going to head over and see if we can find any fossils. We've been here a couple of times and have had really good luck, really good success, but that's what we're doing today. So we're going to spare you the travel time. We still have like another 45 minutes to drive, but you'll be there in 3, 2, 1. Now I am. Woo, that glare is bright. But hey guys, so we have made it, and I'm going to, Josh, why don't you come over this way? And I know I already just played some awesome B-roll of the formation, but why don't you come over a little bit further and we'll get a shot of you standing in front of the formation, and why don't you tell us a little bit about where we are and what we're doing.
All right, hi, my name is Josh, from Trilobyte Studios.
Yes.
Right now, me and Carl are here in West Virginia at the Devonian public fossil site.
Yep.
And we are actually going to be looking for, well, trilobite fossils. This, like Carl said earlier in the video, used to be a...
Did I say that?
Yeah, you said it in the car.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, so do you want me to take over?
Yeah.
Okay, so this used to be a... an old mine where they actually, when they were building the West Virginia Byway way back in the day, so that gives you some kind of idea of where we are. They used to actually come up here and mine this area for stone and rock to put underneath the byway as they were building it up, which is really kind of a shame because I can't even imagine how many amazing fossils might have been destroyed while they were building the byway. But so what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and I've got to put on some boots and we'll do a bit of a montage shot, and then we'll just get right into the search. And as you can see, there's tons and tons of slag on this, which is great for us because we're not super experienced with actually digging for fossils. So what we normally do is we just kind of sift through the slag and see what we can find. We've had, like I said, we've had really good luck here before, and here's hoping that it holds out. So we'll catch up with you guys after I get changed into my boots and the rest of my kit. What do you say, Josh?
What?
Nah. Are you serious?
Yeah.
I wasn't even, you're supposed to re-find it for the camera. What the hell? Oh my God. All right. Hang on a second. Let me get up there. I was literally, I was just filming like B-roll of me putting my bag on.
The funny part is you were standing right here the entire time.
Oh my God. Okay. So real quick background before I show you what Josh found. Whenever we come here, I can never find anything. I look and I look and I look and I don't find stuff. I was going to say a bad word. But he sits down, and 2 seconds later, we find a really, really, hang on, hold that for a second again. Find a really, really nice...
Trilobyte.
Can you guys see that? You can't see that. I'm trying to get this to focus. Look at that. I would be angry.
Mission accomplished.
But I all right, let's go home. All right, so let's get some POV ASMR. I'm just gonna kind of keep walking through the rocks and see if we can find anything.
I think this is the fastest I ever found one.
That was really freaking fast. And the thing is, it's not really skill based up here. It's just kind of luck. You can go and dig into the wall and see what you can find, but you're better off literally just digging through the slag like Josh did and finding stuff that way. Or yeah, just kind of looking and see if there's something laying on top.
Because you gotta really be careful where you step.
Yeah, exactly. You take three steps and you just kind of crush something underfoot. And it's really disheartening. All right, we're gonna get down and dirty and start sifting through some sediment. Okay, Josh is gonna go put his find away in the sick box that we have. I can't see.
Really, Carl?
I'm sorry. Here, take the camera and go show them what we're doing.
Okay, so as he was saying before he cussed.
Bye, guys.
I'm going to be putting the Trilobyte fossil, and I'm trying to not fall down and break my head. Okay, and I'm down. I'm gonna be taking the Trilobyte fossil and putting it in a protection box so it can be safely traveled home. So give me 1 second.
Okay, just got back to the car. And this was the box that he was referring to. And I got the Trilobyte all wrapped up, ready for transport. And we're just gonna slide that right in there. Tissue paper to make it a safer trip so it doesn't break on the way home. And now she's secured.
Let's go see what Carl's been up to.
There he is.
Find
anything?
No, just sadness and disappointment.
Yeah, you might find something eventually.
I mean, I don't have a horseshoe up my tuchus like certain people.
Well, neither do I, but you know, it's just luck.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey guys, so quick PSA, I guess. Remember, if you ever go to public fossil locations, and Josh is not being a very good example of this at the moment, but if you ever go to a public fossil location, don't just trash the place, because you have to think, this has been here for, what, almost 400 million years, and
Devonian, probably longer than that.
Yeah, so anywhere from 400 to 360, and it's been here for a long time, so we don't need humans to come along and trash it. So let's say you're digging along and you pick up a rock and oh no, there's nothing in here. Don't just chuck it. Don't just throw it, because you never know, there might be something in here that's valuable to somebody else. Maybe somebody with a little bit more experience or a little bit more education than either of us and potentially you. So that's a quick PSA. If you're out in a public fossil location and you're digging for fossils, just be respectful, be mindful, and we take nothing but pictures and fossils and leave nothing but footprints. Also, if you're interested in this location and where we are right now, I will put the instructions that we used the first time we came up here to get here in the description down below, or post a link. So, yeah.
Wait, what?
Eastern mountain lions are extinct, dude.
Oh.
They've been extinct for quite a few years now.
Oh.
I mean, the western mountain lion might come out here this way. There's a new area, but yes, Eastern Mountain Lion itself is gone. I think the only one left is the Florida Panther.
Wow. Okay, well.
And Florida.
Well, video coming soon on that, I guess. But what I turned the camera on was to show you guys the color difference in the stratigraphy here. Like, the over here we've got like this brown, and then I know the glare is really bad, but this is like bluish gray, and it's really, really pretty. And I wish I had paid more attention to my geology classes that I had to take at college, because I would really like to know what the difference was here, like what made this blue and what made this brown, like what were the forces at work over the millions of years, or what kind of sediment was it that was fossilized?
The chemical compound.
Yeah, the chemical compounds, like what exactly happened to fossilize it like this. So it's just an amazing formation up here. So if you're in the area or even remotely close and you get the chance to come up here, you definitely should. and check it out. We're gonna be heading over here because there's two parts to this formation, and apparently this part over here, this side, is better for digging around in the wall and finding, finding better specimens. So we're gonna head over here, and you can see, like, we're not the only people who come here. You can see all these tracks and things from where people have been, and it looks like a deer actually came down this way. So anyway, we're gonna dig around in the slag over here and maybe dig into the cliff and see what we can see. So catch you guys if we find something. All right.
Well, while we were digging in this cliff face, I was kind of walking down from out of shot here.
Sliding down.
Well, yeah, sliding, I guess, would be a better view. I found a tail end of a trilobyte. Maybe hard to see, but it's right up here. And it's not that bad. Of course, the mountain, I found its tail and it bit mine. Yeah, I kind of ripped my pants on the way down. So, yeah, kind of.
I have no idea what I just found, guys, but it's like, I don't know, it doesn't look like a trilobite. I don't know if you got, I mean, can you see that? It's like, there you go, it's like ribbed, and it looks kind of like a, I have no idea. If anybody can ID this, I'll probably post it on r/paleontology and see if somebody can ID this for me, but that is really, really cool. Really cool.
West Virginia Devonian fossil site.
Ah,
cool.
So we might have an answer to what I just found, because I have no clue. It definitely wasn't a trilobite. It looked almost like a coral, but I don't even know if corals were around during the... Do we know if corals were around during the Devonian?
Not that I'm aware of.
I don't think so. So hopefully Josh can do a little bit of snooping. Huh. You find another one, I'm gonna kick your booty. Oh, look at it! Oh! Can you even see that? Oh my gosh! It's so cute. Look at him! He's just a little baby.
Hey, Carl.
Yeah?
You know the funny part?
Yeah.
This was right beside the camera the entire time.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Well, kudos to you, Josh.
And my parents always said, don't look down at your feet. Well, it paid off.
Truly, you are more observant than I. Or at least luckier. So, I mean, so far today, it's not been terrible. We've had pretty good success, to be honest.
Got a splinter in my hand.
We found splinters. We found two baby trilobites, a tail, and an actual full trilobite. Well, almost full. Almost full.
Trilobite impression.
Yep, look at that. This trucker, this guy, he just looks down and it's right there. I don't understand. Whatever. I can find trilobites too.
Sure you can, Carl.
just 1 year alone.
Yeah, the first time I ever came here, I was all by myself, and it was a very sad time, because fossil hunting itself is fun, don't get me wrong, but fossil hunting with friends is where it's at.
Unless that said friend finds more than you.
Okay, but when we went and found shark teeth, I found a lot more than you, but see, I'm a generous person. I found like 6 shark teeth, and then at the end of the day, I was like, you know what, I feel bad, so I split them with Josh.
And it's true.
This greedy guy just takes all the trilobites he finds.
Bull crap. I gave you most of them.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
I only have one. Then where are they, Josh? Where are they? I'll say, if, I swear to God, if you say, hey, Carl. My problem is, like, I keep looking at the really big stuff because we were talking earlier while the camera was off. And it's like, you know, looking for fossils and especially trilobites is kind of like fishing. You know, you can sit out there and catch small fish all day if you're using small bait. But if you want to catch the big fish, well, you got to use bigger bait. So essentially, what I mean is, if you want to find if you want to find big trilobites, obviously, you know, you might be able to find pieces of them in small rocks, but you won't be able to find the whole specimen. So, got to look at the big rocks. All right, from now on, we're gonna play a points game. How many points do you want to make one trilobite worth?
1 to 1.
Okay, so 1 to 1, and if it's a half trilobite, it's a half point?
Yeah, that makes sense.
Okay, and if it's if it's anything less than a half, we'll give it like a fourth of a point.
Okay.
Actually, let's do this. Let's do 1 trilobite is 3 points. Half a trilobite is 2 points. And then anything less than half is 1 point.
Okay.
Okay, and what about unknown fossils?
Well, it's unknown, so it's kind of...
2 points?
Yeah, sure.
All right. So right now you've got...
I'm sitting at...
You found...
Full trilobite.
So that's 3.
A tail end of a trilobite.
Yep, so that's 1. That's 4.
And that little baby one encasing that huge rock.
Well, that's technically 3 because it's full, so you're at 7 points. Right now I've got 2, 3... Whatever.
You already lost and you're the one that came up with
it. I'm at 3 points. You're at 7 points. But I guarantee you, by the end of this, I'm going to make it up.
Okay, so about... I want to say about a minute after Carl's whole
contest.
Let's do a contest, I found a trilobite tail end about right there.
It's an impression.
It's an impression.
It doesn't count.
Well, he says it don't count.
I make the rules.
However, I'm pretty sure a museum would just be on my end of a, it counts as a fossil.
Anyway, that doesn't count. We're still looking. I'll find one. Don't you worry, gentle viewer. Just wait till we go and look for shark teeth. I'm gonna kick your ass. I mean, tush. Whoops.
Well, if it's anything like before, we'll find little shark teeth.
And somebody will come along a week later and find a megalodon tooth.
Which has happened.
That's exactly what happened to us, guys. We were, we went to a place called Fossil Beach, like a 4-hour, 5-hour drive. And, cause there was a chance we could find fossilized megalodon teeth. And as long as you tell them what you find, cause it's a national park, as long as you tell them what you find, you're allowed to keep it. And so we went down there and, we found a bunch of little fossilized shark teeth. And then a week later, somebody went down and pulled out a megalodon tooth. So, yeah, and posted on the Facebook page. So what we're planning on doing is, so stay tuned is what I'm saying, is what we're planning on doing is this summer, we'll be heading back down to Fossil Beach and looking for more shark teeth and hopefully a megalodon tooth. So that would be pretty amazing. I think whoever finds the megalodon tooth wins the contest.
Are you gonna keep it going that long?
If I lose. Hey guys, so Josh and I are just about to move locations. We've got the tripod and all the gear, and we're about to move from this side of the cliff back over to where we started. And so it really bugs me when, first of all, littering just bugs me. So if you're on a fossil site, or if you're just somewhere out in nature doing something productive, like hiking or camping or something, and you see trash, just take it with you. Pick it up and take it with you. It takes like 2 seconds. We're gonna pick this up, we're gonna throw it in my car, and we'll throw it away when we get home. Sure, it's just gonna wind up in a landfill somewhere, but it's better than...
Actually, no.
It's better than out here.
I take these and collect them and turn them into recyclable cans.
Well, never mind then. That's going to be recycled.
Hey.
Okay, Carl, what are we doing?
Well, we are once again transferring all the little bitty fossils and impressions that we found into our beautiful storage box here in the glorious backseat.
I am sorry about the glare, people.
Of my car. Yeah, it's going to be pretty rough. Can't really help that.
The sun is not in a position that is helping us right now.
But anyway.
However, it is making Carl stand out.
Hey.
So
we're going to be putting all these little fellas in some tissue paper, something nice and soft. That way we can put them in the storage box and transport them easily back to civilization. Don't want to make more litter.
By the way, are you rolling?
Yeah, I know. You don't have to whisper. It's a reality show.
I found some stuff, guys. Show you when we're done.
Oh my god, dude.
Holy shit.
Oh shoot, guys. Okay, I gotta come up there. Oh. Oh.
You finally found something.
I found, not just something. This is a, oh my, hang on guys. I'm making my way uptown. Walking kind of carefully because I've got a really awesome find. And I don't want to fall on my tuchus and break my face. Oh my god, dude. And ladies, you never know. look at this. Let's not die here, Carl. Look at that. Look at that. Can you see it? Oh man, look at that, guys. Look at that. That is a full trilobite specimen in that rock. Now, if I was a braver man, I would definitely try to break this rock open and get to the rest of the specimen, but I am not a braver man. And this is, wow. I am over the moon.
Wow.
Yeah.
Look at that fossil. Does it look like the same one you found earlier?
You mean the impression?
That really weird one.
Yes and no. This one's definitely a trilobite. This is a full trilobite, just chilling in that mudstone. Oh man, guys, look at that. All right. Anyway, you want to cut the time lapse?
Yeah, that'd be fine.
All right, cutting time lapse. All right. Okay, guys, we're about to pack it in for the day. We've been out here for about 3 hours, 3.5 hours. I found this specimen, which is just, oh man, I'm over the moon about this. But we are going to head back to the car now. Josh has got the rest of the finds that we found today. Well, minus the ones that are already in the car. And what we'll do is we'll probably get back to civilization and then give you guys a recap of what we found today and tally up the points. I'm excited now. All right, guys, so we're back, obviously, in civilization. And what we're gonna do now is we're going to crack open the box of goodies. And
look at Carl's nice blanket.
Look at my blanket. Oh, careful, there's actually a fossil. I didn't bother wrapping that last one. I just put it in the
thanks for letting me know that.
That could have gotten ugly. Real quick.
So anyway, we're going to pull out all the fossils. We'll put Josh's stuff in a pile, we'll put my stuff in a pile, then we'll tally up.
Remember which pile what?
Then we'll tally up the points and I will proceed to kick Josh's ass. So let's do it. Okay, guys, well, it's very bright out. I have to hold the camera really high so you can actually see Josh.
There we go. I'm not even in the... There we go. Thanks, Carl.
Anyway,
So what you just saw was some awesome B-roll of the everything we just found. And so we're gonna tally up the points now.
I'm pretty sure you won.
All right, so on the left here, we've got Josh's stuff, which the first trilobite that we found of the day. Here is the teeny weeny little baby trilobite. You can see it right there. Probably put like a little circle on it.
Hold on.
Oh yeah, pull out your knife and right there. Then the next one, so okay, this is 1 point, or this is 3 points. This is 3 points, because they're technically still full, so that's six. You can see the trilobite butt there. so what was that? That's 1 point?
It's a half point, because it was a half a fossil.
No, we went 3 for a whole, 2 for half, and then 1 point for anything less than a half.
Okay. Yeah.
So we'll say, oh, we'll give you 2 points there. Then this was an impression, which you can see there. We're not really counting impressions in the point tally, which I think if we did, you might actually still win. What was this one? I keep losing this one. Ah, right. Another little impression right there. I don't know how well you all can see that. And this one down here was a very good impression. You can see that very clearly. All right. So then over to my stuff, I've got these little, I guess, I don't really even know what they are, but they're just random fossils in these rocks. There's also a couple more on the back of this one. Got to be careful down in that area. Got to be careful with, I just saw it. Oh well. Same on this one. There's some shells and all kinds of neat stuff on this one. And if I remember right, oh no, no, it was just on the front of this one. And then down here, I've got basically a quarter of a trilobite, so that's 1 point. Here's an impression that I found. Yep, I'm just trying to give them a decent angle so you can actually see the ridges of the impression. Swear it's there. Oh, no. No, it's not. It's on this side. We're idiots. There it is. Now you can see the ridges. And then I found this weird thing, which is just like a random fossil. I don't exactly know what it is. If anybody does, please let us know in the comments down below. And like I said before, I'll be posting on r/paleontology. Hopefully someone can help us out. And last, we've got this one, which obviously is a full trilobite with the head intact.
You know that's bigger, the biggest one we ever found.
That is the biggest trilobite we've ever found. It's as big as my finger, which granted isn't very big. But
not really.
It's as big as my finger. So that's what, 3 points, 1 point, 2 point, 2 point. So that's
because we said this one had multiple fossils in it.
Yeah, but that feels like cheating.
And?
No, okay, so 2 points, 4 points, 5 points. I'm at 8 points. You've got, or wait, no, I'm at 10 points because 2, 4, 6, 9, 10. So you've got 3, 6. Was this an impression? Or, oh, no, that's the button. 7. This was another impression, that was an impression, and a last impression. So, the total stands at Carl 10, Josh 7. But,
And this is coming from a guy who complained about losing.
I did complain, okay, but that's the plan, right? That's the strat. You complain the entire time about losing, and then you just come back from behind and win.
Okay.
Thank you so much for watching, guys. We really appreciate it. If you like what you saw, go ahead and hit the subscribe button, like button, leave a comment, let us know down below how big of idiots we are, and
pretty big.
And we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.